I'd like to call on the brothers from Chicago to present a couple of plaques that we have generated. Let me read this.
We have here two sit-down pioneer awards. This sit-down pioneer award is hereby granted to Geraldine Blankenship for providing inspirational leadership and showing the way to new generations of sit-downers in solidarity from the 2008 sit-downers of Republic Windows and Doors.
Inside the plants, we had 4,000 or 5,000 outside of the plants bringing food and keeping the place shut down. We did not let any management in of any kind. Once they went out, they were out, period. And we had to fight the police to do that, too. They tried the tear gas, throw it into the windows to get the strikers off, so the remedy for that was chop all the windows out, get ventilation, and that was done. The strike was getting vicious and mean. After about the 20th day of the strike, which lasted 44 days, Governor Frank Fitzgerald, or Murphy, Frank Murphy, sent the National Guard in there and got the strikers out the plant and kept the plants closed. At that point, the bloodshed was stopped because there was bloodshed down in the hole, shitty plant floor. And official body. The police was there with clubs beating women like this. I got DVD pictures made now of all the tapes that I've had. I've been following the labor movement for 72 years in Flint. And I got lots of records of this. They were vicious, the police and the National Guard. The judges in Flint, it's all on the payroll of General Motors. So they were going to threaten to put all the strikers in jail. That didn't bother us at all. The jails are not that big. We finally won. After 44 days, on February the 11th, General Motors gave in and decided they would negotiate. I have copies right here now of the original agreement where they recognized the UAW-CIO as the bargaining agent for all of their plants. That was our Bible and Constitution. Each of the 43 plants in the country had to hammer out their own local agreements. This is where we have all the individual plants throughout the country that has contracts, but they'll all have to conform to the national agreement. And it's still in effect now. We updated it every 4 years by new contracts, and our benefits have been greatly increased. Our pensions are good now. But I am really wondering if General Motors, Ford, and Chrysler is going to be around for a while. I'm really careful of Chrysler. General Motors hasn't learned a thing in the last 50 years. If you ask them guys what the name is, they have a long time figuring out who they are. There's that stupid. You see that in the newsreels when they're in Congress, being questioned. Yeah. They're the most ill-prepared people I've ever met in my life. Yeah. And it shows. They're not very good financial straits right now. That's all their own fault. We are really happy to be retirees. I've been retired now 28 years. I started there in 1936 in Buick in the Foundry. That was no vacation spot. It was terrible. And we established the idea in this country. We really made the middle class. The conditions where we had the sit-down strike. We got some recognition.